गुड मॉर्निंग डियर चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू? होप ऑल ऑफ यूर सेफ एंड फाइन एट योर होम। फॉर गेटिंग सक्सेस देयर इज ओनली वन लेसन, कीप योर फोकस ऑन गोल एंड गो फॉर इट विथ पैशन। गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। ओके, विथ दिस ब्यूटिफुल कोटेशन वील स्टार्ट आवर लेसन टूडे। सो वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट कंप्यूटर नेटवर्क्स एंड प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव स्टडी अबाउट गाइडेड मीडिया और वी कैन टेल वायर्ड मीडिया। टूडे वील लर्न अबाउट वायरलेस मीडिया। फॉर वायरलेस कम्युनिकेशन टू टेक प्लेस वी रिक्वायर डाटा टू बी ट्रांसपोर्टेड विदाउट वायर्स। मीन्स प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव रेड अबाउट ट्विस्टेड पेयर, कोएक्सियल केबल, फाइबर ऑप्टिक केबल। दैट मीन्स दैट इज ए फिजिकल पाथ बिटवीन द सेंडर एंड द रिसीवर for the data transmission. But in wireless media, there will be no physical medium. Data will be transmitted wirelessly. This data is transported using what we call signals, electromagnetic waves. Signals are nothing but your electromagnetic waves. So how data transmission takes place? Now the question comes, how can we create signals to be sent over wireless? Means how these electromagnetic waves will be created by us. It all starts at the transmitter, where an oscillator generates periodic wave. This signal propagates through internal wires of the device up to the antenna. Since the antenna is a conductor, electric current goes further towards the end of the antenna. The antenna then radiates the alternating current as an electromagnetic wave. This is where wireless starts. That is, antenna converts electric current into waves. See, you may find difficult to understand this paragraph. This is not in your book also, but for make you understand, I have collected it. That means wherever you are watching wireless connection, it may be you must have seen telephone towers are there, TV antenna is also there. So means using those antennas only data transmission takes place wirelessly. Okay, and this is how it all starts with at the transmitter, where an oscillator generates periodic wave. This signal propagates through internal wires of the device up to the antenna. Since antenna is a conductor, electric current goes further towards the end of the antenna. That means you use some device like your transmitter, oscillator and other devices, which they will create electromagnetic waves, and that will pass through the internal wires of the device up to the antenna. Okay, since the antenna is a conductor, electric current goes further towards the end of the antenna. The antenna then radiates the alternating current as an electromagnetic wave. This is where wireless starts. That is, antenna converts electric current into waves. That means in a wireless media, the antenna is the main device which converts your digital signal to wireless data, and again wireless signal back into digital data. So the antenna converts digital signals to wireless data at the sender's end, and wireless signals back into digital data at the receiver's end. That means, now you come to understand, when we will go for wireless data connection, we have to take the help of an antenna. Okay, now next comes where this wireless data we are using. Okay, so now let us see what are the areas where it can be applied to. In most cases, we use wireless communication to transmit data. It can be either in one direction like radio or TV broadcasting, or two-way data transfer where one entity acts as a transmitter and other as a receiver. And in the second scenario, we can use satellites, Wi-Fi access points or mobile networks like 3G, 4G or upcoming 5G as the intermediate points which help achieve such communication between the transmitter and the receiver. That means we are using, see, many things shown in the picture, from mobile communication is also there, TV broadcasting is also there, FM radio is also there. So many places are there where using that wireless communication medium, in our daily life. Okay, so it is either in one direction like radio or TV broadcasting, or it can be a two-way transmission. So one-way like means, suppose in a TV and radio, what is actually happening? Whatever programs are coming, we are watching. We are not able to send anything to that device. So it is a one-way communication. So they are also like radio or TV broadcasting. But sometimes two-way data transmission is also there, just like mobile. Sometimes you are sending it and sometimes you are receiving it also. So that is, you can tell internet also, two-way data transfer where one entity acts as a transmitter and other as a receiver. Means two ways will be there. In the second scenario, we can use satellites, Wi-Fi access points, or mobile networks like 3G or 4G or upcoming 5G, that also you know, as the intermediate points which help achieve such communication between the transmitter and the receiver. If it will be a two-way connection, then there will be a sender and the receiver, then we can use your satellites, Wi-Fi access points or mobile networks. And sometimes it is a one-way communication, that is your radio or TV broadcasting. Okay, so next see. Unguided transmission media means wireless media, all of you know, and this is our three types. Okay, an unguided transmission media transmits the electromagnetic waves without using any physical medium like your guided media. Therefore, it is also known as your wireless transmission media also. In unguided media, air is the media through which the electromagnetic energy can flow easily. Okay, so whatever you think, that is the medium is our air. Unguided transmission is broadly classified into three categories. There, one is your infrared, one is your microwave, and another one is your radio wave. Infrared, previous class also, just I told you that in TV remote we are using infrared. So today, details will read about the infrared. Infrared transmission is a wireless technology used for communication over short ranges. Very small distance, you must have seen, just a meter distance we are sitting in front of your TV and then handling it with a remote. The frequency of the infrared is in the range of 300 gigahertz to 400 terahertz. Okay, it is very small. It is used for short range communication such as data transfer between two cell phones. When you are using Bluetooth to transfer data from one device to another, TV remote operation, data transfer between a computer and a cell phone resides in the same closed area. Then that transmission comes under the category of your infrared. It supports high bandwidth and hence the data transmission rate will be very high. Infrared waves cannot penetrate the walls. Therefore, the infrared communication in one room cannot be interrupted by the nearby room. Say, what is the meaning of this? That means it cannot penetrate the wall. Sitting in one room, suppose your TV is in another room and you are sitting in another one room, and if you want to handle that using a remote, it will not be possible. Okay, that because these rays are not so capable to penetrate through the walls. And suppose you are using your Bluetooth to transfer data in one room and TV also connecting in another room, then that will not be, no interference will happen, you can do it both the places, you can do it. So that is the meaning, that infrared waves cannot penetrate the walls. Therefore, the infrared communication in one room cannot be interrupted by the nearby rooms. Okay, so this is all about an infrared. We are using it for a very short range transmission of your data. The frequency is your 300 gigahertz to 400 terahertz. Okay, and it is used for between two cell phones for data transfer, TV remote operation, data transfer between a computer and a cell phone. Sometimes you are using music system also for handling with a remote also. So these are comes under your infrared. Okay, so next comes to your radio waves. What are these radio waves? Radio waves are the electromagnetic waves that are transmitted in all the directions of free space. Okay, radio waves are omnidirectional. Omnidirectional means it can travel in any direction. That is, the signals are propagated in all the directions. The range in frequencies of radio wave is from 3 kilohertz to 1 gigahertz. In the case of radio waves, the sending and receiving antenna are not aligned. That is, the wave sent by the sending antenna can be received by any receiving antenna. An example of the radio wave is FM radio. Okay, that means for FM radio, we don't use any, means aligned antennas are not there. Okay, signal can be travel in any directions, and it is your one picture is there also. Just like it is earth surface, then antennas will be there too, which will transmit the signals from ground waves. Okay, and this is used in your FM radio. So radio waves are the electromagnetic waves that are transmitted in all the directions of free space. Radio waves are omnidirectional, that is, the signals are propagated in all the directions. The range in frequencies of radio wave is from 3 kilohertz to 1 gigahertz. In the case of radio waves, the sending and the receiving antenna are not aligned. That is, the wave sent by the sending antenna can be received by any receiving antenna. An example of the radio wave is FM radio. Okay, FM radio, all of you are listening, 92.7 BKFM. So like that only, that is means programs are transmitted through the radio waves frequencies 3 kilohertz to 1 gigahertz, and it can travel in any direction. Okay, so next comes to where actually radio waves are used. Radio wave is used for multicasting when there is one sender and many receiver. Just like FM radio, one sender is there, any particular company is sending the signals, programs, whatever you tell, and many receivers are there. And FM radio, television, cordless phones are examples of radio waves. Radio transmission is mainly used for wide area networks. Radio waves cover a large area and they can penetrate the walls. See, the signals are coming to our house, penetrating our walls. Okay, so radio transmission provides a higher data transmission rate. And FM radio, television, cordless phones, radio waves are used. Okay, so next is your microwave. Microwave include a line of sight transmission. That is, the sending and receiving antennas that need to be properly aligned with each other. The distance is directly proportional to the height of the antenna which is covered by the signal. In mobile phone communication and television distribution, these are majorly used. See, you must have seen telephone towers are there, and they must be of equal distance, and the distance is proportional to the height of the antenna also. So picture is also there. They see these two antennas are of equal height, line of transmission it maintains, which is not maintained in the case of your radio wave. Okay, so due to the unidirectional data travels in one direction only, radio waves travels in, it is, that was omnidirectional, and it is a one direction. Due to the unidirectional properties of microwave, they are very useful when unicast, one-to-one communication is needed between the sender and the receiver. So cellular phones, whenever we are using, that is one-to-one communication, where we are using your microwaves. Cellular phones, satellite networks, and wireless LANs are using microwaves. Okay, so this is all about your microwave. Now comes to your protocol. Protocol is a set of rules and guidelines for transmitting data between network devices. You know that for doing any work, there must be certain rules and regulations. So for transmission of data also, there are some rules and regulations when we transmit data over network. Okay, and those set of rules and guidelines are known as your protocols. Different protocols are used for different purpose. You must have heard about TCP IP, Transmission Control Protocol, Internet Protocol, HTTP, Hypertext Transfer Protocol. So SMTP is there, Simple Mail Transfer Protocol. FTP is there, File Transfer Protocol. So different work, there is a protocol. Means there are some rules how it will work. So most protocols use packet switching technique for data transfer. So what is this packet switching technique? In this technique, the data to be exchanged is broken into small chunks called packets. You know that suppose you are sending one message, that message you have typed in characters, but you know that no characters cannot travel, so it will convert into signals. Signals means in the form of 0 and 1. So when the data means whole message will be converted into 0 and 1, that message will be divided into small parts known as your chunks and or packets. Each packet contains the sender's and receiver's address and the sequence number. Okay, since it something will divide, then we have to keep track how to again rearrange it. So there will be a serial number, and for each packet there will be sender address and receiver address will be attached automatically. So what is the sender and receiver? Actually your IP address of your computer. So means say, from where it will go and from where it is we are sending. So both senders and receivers address will be there. Different packets of single message can take different paths to reach the receiver. There is no particular path, so it can travel in any path to reach to the receiver. However, once all the packets arrive at the destination, they are compiled back into the original message. So I told no, so whenever we will divide the data into small chunks, so there will be serial number. Otherwise, we cannot get the original message back at the receiver send. So there will be a serial for each packet, and every packet there will be a sender address and the receiver address. So when the data will travel in any path and when it will reach at the destination computer, again it will be reassembled to get the original message. And which protocols are using will use to do this type of work, or whatever we are using to do this packet switching, to make packets and sending the packets and rearranging it at the destination, so we'll read it in the next class. Okay, and only this protocol last class when say protocol will over, then we'll come to the end of this chapter. Okay, and any doubt you send message through campus care also. Whatever assignment I am giving, note down it in your copy. It will be helpful for your exam. Sometimes I am giving extra notes for your better understanding. So if you will read it, there is no harm. We are not studying for exam. We are studying for gaining knowledge. So you just keep it in mind. Some of you asked me in campus care that question, sometimes answers are very long. So see, in the exam you will be asked only to write 2 points or 3 points, but I am giving that you read it, write it, and you know the things. So whether it will be asked in exam or not, you don't bother. Okay, you understand the facts and gain some knowledge. Okay, so thank